Every day of our lives, we make judgments about art, politics, people. And though we may try to be open to something or someone new and different, the truth is, most of us are a lot more closed off than we realize. In 1965, there were things I didn't like or understand that I came to appreciate much later in life. This painting was not one of them.
I hate it.
I think it's kind of nice. If you look at it this way, it looks kind of like an elephant.
I think it looks like Lyndon Johnson's appendix scar.
Give it a week or two. You don't change your mind, I'll come pick it up. At the least, I get to see you again.
George Pentecost, if that artist could throw paint like you throw compliments, he'd be a huge success.
By the way, if you don't yet have an escort for the Founders Ball at the club, I would be honored to accompany you.
Well, I don't know if I'll be in town, but if I am, I will definitely consider your gracious invitation.
Well, I see myself out.
Taddy, you didn't tell me you're going away again.
No, I'm not.
A girl should never accept the first invitation.
I think I might let Georgie Porgy just dangle for a little while. Dangle?
Oh, that's advanced. You need to start with the basics, which is why I have decided to enroll you in junior cotillion with Miss Dubois.
No! What's junior cotillion?
It's torture!
It's where girls and boys learn the proper way to sit, stand, talk, eat, and not talk back to their mamas.
Fine. She can sign me up, but she can't make me go.
And if you don't go, I'll take away your horse. A cotillion also teaches you to talk softer.
I think it sounds like fun.
Good, because you're taking it with me.
Cotillion. It sounded so elegant, like something out of Gone with the Wind. There was only one problem. Getting my family to let me go.
A little trouble sleeping.
I was up half the night trying to come up with designs for new couches.
You know what I do when I can't sleep? I count fish.
Fish? Why not sheep?
Too noisy. Fish don't bleat. They just drift quietly by my eyes like this.
Heshy, sweetheart, if you ever date, I wouldn't mention this right away.
Okay. But it works.
Before the conversation took another of the bizarre turns our family was famous for, I decided to jump in.
Grace is taking a cotillion class, and she wants me to take it with her.
Cotillion? What is that, another one of those Catholic things?
No, it's about etiquette. It teaches you how to sit, stand, and eat.
You're already sitting, and you were just standing, and in a minute you're going to eat. So what's to learn?
You get poise and self-confidence. And I think they serve little tea cakes, so you won't have to buy me as much food.
Who was I kidding? My parents would never go for something like this.
Okay.
Really?
Sure. What have I always told you? You should always act like a lady, like your mother.
Thank you, David.
Besides, when I was a boy in Poland, we had classes in art, music, fencing.
Fencing?
Of course. What do you think? We sat around watching television? People fence.
I just never knew anyone who fenced before.
Sure you did. Your cousin Jake fenced until the cops found him trying to sell a stolen radio.
While my parents decided to let me expand my horizons.
Ooh-wee, who's reading all this?
Oh, I am.
My mother was about to expand hers, whether she wanted to or not.
William Faulkner, Ernest Hemingway. You've got a big old brain there, don't you?
I like to read. It relaxes me.
You know, I'm a reader, too.
Oh, in fact, me and some girlfriends have a little book club. Maybe you'd like to join.
No, I don't think so, Shirley. I mean, what with work and everything at home?
Eddie, I'm sure it'll be fine for one night.
Great. It's tonight, my place, 7 o'clock. And it's potluck, so bring a dish. Oh, you're just going to love Lurleen, Wanda, Joe, and Pearlie Mae. I just know it. Can't wait.
Until one has learned the proper use of cutlery, one cannot consider oneself truly civilized.
That's right. Forget the wheel, the printing press, or the splitting of the atom. According to Mrs. Dubois,
if you don't know which fork to use, you might as well be swinging through the trees.
And we all were, except for young Brian.
Mrs. Dubois, these pettifogs are for you.
A boy born for cotillion.
Thank you, Brian.
Unlike Grace, who had to be blackmailed to attend.
Now we shall begin with dancing. Gentlemen, I want you to line up opposite the ladies.
It didn't matter, though. Like Taddy, all the boys fought to be her partner. But me, I held my breath. Who would I end up with?
Hello.
Warren, you are late. A gentleman never keeps a lady waiting.
Sorry.
Well, come in and take your place opposite, Hannah. Gentlemen, extend your right hand. Ladies, place your left hand on top.
His hand was cold and clammy, and I was wearing gloves. He stared at me through thick lenses. Do I need to mention he was a mouth breather? How much worse could it get? Much.
America, one of these real families will get the chance to star in a sitcom based on their lives. Tonight is your chance to catch up on the competition with back-to-back bonus episodes of My Life is a Sitcom at 7, 6 Central. And Monday, don't miss an all-new episode with the Lucas Twins. Let's recap. My Life is a Sitcom back-to-back bonus episodes tonight at 7, 6 Central, and an all-new episode Monday at 8, 7 Central on the XYZ on ABC Family.
Maya Marie never had to open a cookbook in her life, but she did ask Olive Garden what goes into their new chicken castellina. It's wonderful ingredients like sun-dried tomatoes sauteed with chicken and a creamy wine and smoked cheese sauce for just $8.95. Mm. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
It's the power of the sun. In liquid form. The power pack taste of Sunny D.
Contains as much cancer-causing tar as 4 cigarettes. Marijuana, it's more harmful than we all thought.
I've just noticed that women like chocolate more than men.
That's a myth.
Guys just don't seem to have that relationship.
You'll never hear a man like,
oh God.
We need our Hershey more than the average guy.
I think we have our own emotional reasons.
She loves me, she loves me not.
Sometimes I think that maybe you don't really get it.
Get what?
The way to a woman's heart.
Hershey's.
The classic piece of chocolate.
I think that everyone probably needs about the same amount of chocolate to be happy.
In 4 days,
will you marry me?
Oh my God.
First love.
You won't come?
I can't.
Girl I knew used to be fearless.
Gets a second chance.
Hey cowboy, you owe me a dance.
Reese Witherspoon, Sweet Home Alabama. Own it on DVD and video February 4th.
You're still not sleeping, huh?
No.
Did you try counting fish?
I counted fish. By size, by color, by personality. Some of them had names, some had jobs. I was up all night.
Don't worry. I'm working on something. Help is on the way.
Wonderful.
Hi.
Anna, how was Cotillion? Wait a minute. Let me see. You look the same to me.
It was fun.
Oh, yes, she is. A little debutante. So what did you do there?
We danced.
And Warren crushed several of my toes.
We learned to curtsy and bow.
And he accidentally hit me in the chest with his head.
And how to help a boy pin a corsage on you.
Fortunately, he'd missed a major artery.
Corsage? Classy.
I'm going. Ma, I need the potluck you made.
Oh, okay.
How was Cotillion? Fun.
Oh, that's nice.
How do I look? I have no idea what these women are going to be like.
Every people are people. You'll have a wonderful time, just like Hannah did. Right, Hannah?
Uh-huh.
Here you are.
You made Kishka? What were you thinking?
Who doesn't love my Kishka?
Kishka? What exactly is...
It's cow intestine. Stuffed with meat, herbs, and spices.
Huh. What do you know? I'm sure it's delicious, and I'm going to try some. Oh, not that much. I'm watching my way.
Oh, right.
What the hay? Me too. And you've got to try ours. Mine is the marshmallow fruit salad with mayonnaise dressing.
I made the iceberg lettuce with mayonnaise and peas.
And I did the ham spread with mayonnaise and mustard dip. So good on Wonder Bread.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the macaroni and cheese.
Let me guess. Yours has the mayonnaise center.
Why would you put mayonnaise in macaroni and cheese?
Crazy.
So, the judge said, you've been married 10 years. How much of that time has Earl been drinking? And I said, I had to use a fireman's carry to get him home from the wedding. Does that give you an idea?
Oh, no, they're not drinking, they're fighting.
Say, Evelyn, you're being so quiet. Is this kind of talk painful?
No. No.
Well, what's your husband's weakness?
Sometimes he worries too much. And occasionally, I have to remind him to take out the garbage.
Oh.
And he can be a little nervous.
Why don't we talk about what we're going to read next?
Yes. I've thought of several choices. All of them Southern.
Oh.
Carson McCullers' The Heart is a Lonely Hunter, Faulkner's As I Lay Dying, and William Goyen's House of Breath.
Oh. What about Passion on the Beach?
Good choice. I don't know it.
Oh, it's the sequel to Passion on the Mountain.
Oh, we've read all 16 in the series. The first was Passion on the Prairie.
Oh, my God. Remember that opening scene with Cochise and the settlers? Wow!
Good. And when they're not bailing their husbands out of jail, they're drowning their sorrows in a sea of mayonnaise. And they hated the Kishka.
Kishka's an acquired taste.
I saw Pearlie Mae hide hers in the plastic plant. I'm not going back.
All right, you tried it. It wasn't for you. Shirley will understand.
What's that?
Well, since counting fish didn't work, as she thought maybe the sound of a babbling brook might relax me.
Sounds like a faucet.
It is. He said it would take a mile of extension cord to get the real thing. Good night.
Night.
Now we have to go to the bathroom.
Me too.
In fact, she is the one I'm meant to be with. We would be honored if you would cater our humble wedding.
Really?
She's not the one. Her fiancé, who is by definition the one, makes me at best the two.
The One, an ABC Family original movie, premieres Sunday, February 9th at 8, 7 Central.
I try to swim a couple laps every morning, but never the long way, just from here to there.
I did an all-garlic diet. Lost some friends that way.
Well, I was on a, let's call it a one-meal-a-day diet. Terrible diet, because midnight, every night, I was eating the next meal.
If these people can lose weight, so can you. A university study found that replacing two meals a day with a bowl of Special K or Smart Start cereals for 2 weeks could help you lose up to 6 pounds. Diet and exercise are important parts of a healthy lifestyle.
Quick diets, the olive oil diet. You're not on that one long.
Okay, okay, we're rolling, and action!
It's new.
Are you ready?
Smile for the cameras. It's different.
A whole new direction.
Come on, we're gonna hit the ride.
It's one of a kind.
One of a kind?
Sounds like a good story to me.
This is brilliant.
The all-new Dalmatians movie, 101 Dalmatians 2, Patches London Adventure, rated G.
The gift of inspiration.
It makes me smile a lot.
Now on Disney DVD and video.
No way.
Never seen an angel with wings?
No.
Ever heard of 1-800-COLLECT?
Who has it? When you want to call collect, dial 1-800-COLLECT.
Brawn and Brett. I like that. 1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two. That's the break.
Get your break going with the light, crispy, chocolatey taste of a Kit Kat.
Discount Carpet Supermart Outlet, exit 5 off Everett Road, Albany.
First quality carpeting at unbelievable Mill Direct discounts. Hundreds and hundreds of rugs, remnants, and full rolls. Everything is in stock, every style, every color, every size. At Discount Carpet Supermart Outlet, we do it all. Cut, bind, deliver, and install. Get the finest selection of carpet at rock bottom prices at Discount Carpet Supermart Outlet. Exit 5 off Everett Road, left at Quality Inn, onto Watervliet Avenue, Albany.
What if you could create your own primetime lineup? What if you could record all your favorite shows automatically? What if you could pause live TV when the phone rings?
Put your TV on your schedule. Automatically record shows to watch them when you want. The new digital video recorder from Time Warner Cable. Available only with Time Warner Digital Cable. Call today and connect 1-866-321-CABLE.
The minute Shirley comes in, I'm going to tell her. You'll probably be relieved. I mean, I'm sure they were as uncomfortable as I was.
Well, wasn't that the best evening? Oh, Mr. Rayburn, we had so much fun.
Shirley? Shirley.
Oh, it was such a treat having you there. And that kissy thing was so good. Shirley, here. I bought you a copy of the book on my way in, just by way of thanking you for coming. It meant a lot to me. It really did.
I had fun, too.
In my next class, I was hoping things would improve.
Remember tiny sips, like Brian.
All right, everyone. Soup spoons down.
But unfortunately, in the world of cotillion, Warren and I were an item.
We are now going to engage in polite dinner conversation. I want every lady to look to the gentleman on her left.
What could I talk to him about? His sinus condition? Why couldn't I be more like Grace? She didn't seem to have any trouble relating to her dinner partner. But I forged on.
Do you have a favorite subject in school?
Science. In particular, the study of plants and their ability to enter a state similar to hibernation when climactic conditions dictate, and then regenerate themselves when...
He didn't take a breath until the main course was served. It was like I was the first person who'd ever asked him a direct question. All I knew was that I'd released a well of passion as deep as it was unexpected.
I want a quick cotillion.
Why?
Grandma Ida's right. I already know how to sit and stand. I don't need lessons.
And your parents, they work very hard to afford to send you to things like this.
Hannah, this is what you wanted, and you should finish what you start.
But
your father's right, Hannah. You know, we all have to
do things we don't want to do.
Yes.
Since running water had failed, Uncle Heshy had made a new tape, Sounds of the Forest, recorded 5 feet outside our back door.
Heshy, what are you doing out there?
Ma, quiet. I'm making a tape for David. You left the door open. Mosquitoes are getting in.
That Saturday, I had an unexpected visitor.
Hello. Warren? I was in the neighborhood, well.
Meanwhile, Grace was suffering through a home invasion of her own. And in an effort to further defy Taddy, she handled it in a way that can only be described as counter-cotillion.
Thank you.
But I wasn't as advanced as Grace.
I'm going to Lacey Park to search for some fungus for an experiment. Would you like to come?
He was a charmer, all right.
I've got a lot of homework. I could help. No, that's okay. That would be like cheating. I admire your integrity. Maybe tomorrow? No, more homework. Monday after school. More homework. And a funeral. In Raleigh. Oh. Who died? My uncle.
Oh, yeah. I had integrity. I was killing off relatives to avoid him. That night, my father was ready to get rid of a relative, too.
Brother, you tell me. Might as well go work.
Now I'm awake.
So read your romance novel. If it's as bad as you think, you'll be out in no time.
Spoiled, beautiful Samantha McIntyre stood on the beach as a soft breeze ruffled her flimsy negligee. "You're up late," said a deep baritone voice behind her. She turned to see Brett Cummings, her new horse trainer, striding toward her in a pair of swim trunks that only served to accentuate his muscular thighs and slim waist.
David. It's late. Why don't you come to bed?
I don't think I could sleep.
I don't want you to.
That night, my father finally did fall asleep. And when he did, he slept extremely well.
Tonight on the XYZ on ABC Family, it's an hour of My Life as a Sitcom, Police Academy 2, more My Life as a Sitcom, then Last Resort. And get an XYZ Minute at the top of every hour.
Andy Anderson from Composure Magazine. I could start by dating a guy, then drive him away, doing everything girls do wrong in relationships.
I can make a woman fall head over heels, hit him up.
Hi.
You are falling in love with me.
I'm gonna make you wish you were dead.
Hi.
Gang's
all here. Thank you. And after all this, he still didn't leave you?
True or false? All's fair in love and war.
True. How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. Rated PG-13. Sneak preview tomorrow. Check local listings.
It's the power of the sun. In liquid form. The power pack taste of Sunny D.
Unleash the power of the sun.
Sometimes when we turn.
love Geico?
I want to hold you till I die. Till we both break down.
Because 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Till the fear in me subsides.
I usually break it into pieces. That way, you know, you trick your mind into thinking there's more than there actually is. It's a good feeling. It's like, like getting a big hug from somebody you haven't seen in a long time. That's what Hershey feels like to me.
Flavor is coming your way. Introducing Domino's Dots, 360 degrees of all-around gooey, delicious cinnamon fun. Get an order free when you buy a large one-topping pizza for $9.99. Only from Domino's. Domino's Dots, now in a manageable size.
I don't know. They look pretty big to me.
Get the door, quick. It's free Domino's Dots.
Ever wondered what it's really like to be a soldier?
What do you got?
I have a SIP rep from Alpha Company.
CT, ready to be verified. Verified!
Put yourself in the picture with this free video. You'll see over 200 great jobs in the Army and over 180 in the Army Reserve. You'll also see what skills you learn, how you can earn money for college, even what soldiers do in their free time. Call 1-800-984-ARMY now and get this free t-shirt and your free video. Put yourself in the picture and see what it's really like to become an Army of One.
It keeps getting worse. Saturday, he came to my house. I had three of them at mine.
What'd you do?
I threw candy at them.
Hannah? I thought you were going to a funeral.
I was. But... he... woke up. Right in the casket.
Wow.
It was a miracle.
That's amazing. So, you want to go looking for fungus?
Go home.
I could walk you.
You don't have to.
I want to.
Okay, I've been polite. I tried to be gracious, but he wouldn't stop. And suddenly I snapped.
Well, I don't. I don't want you to walk me home or dance with me or ask me to pick fungus. I just want you to leave me alone.
Never forget the expression on his face.
I'm sorry.
Warren dropped out of Cotillion, and his family moved away not long after. Years later, I saw him on the news, receiving an award for discovering a cancer-fighting enzyme in a rare fungus.
Hello.
He was eloquent and assured. A remarkable human being. He had been that at 12. But of course, I'd been unable to see it. And I've always regretted that.
I know.
My mother had misjudged the women in the book club as well.
Elaine, what you do with mayonnaise, it's a miracle.
But luckily, she discovered her mistake in time. Over the years that they met, she even got them to read an occasional classic. Lady Chatterley's Lover was a big hit. As for Taddy, unfortunately, she misjudged the abstract, which sold at auction years later for $500,000. But then everyone makes misjudgments. Some cost financially, some cost physically. And some emotionally. But in truth, they all cost.
America, you've met the Millers, and so far, our celebrity judges think they're funny enough to star in their own sitcom. But now, they face off against the Lucas twins. Here's the XYZ on how to tell them apart. Jennifer belches louder than Allison. Will this date be able to tell them apart?
Ooh, he has no clue.
Are these outrageous twins funny enough to star in their own primetime show? An all-new My Life is a Sitcom, Monday at 8, 7 Central on the XYZ on ABC Family.